Hello! In this tutorial, I will demonstrate how to do shadow studies in Revit using Shadow Colour. Shadow Colour allows you to select a different color for elements in Revit and export shadow study images and GIF animations in no time. To learn more and download the Revit add-in, visit our website, linked in the description below. The first step is to set up the Revit view for shadow study. We only need to set up one view. I will make sure the view is cropped and the shadows are on. Under the sun settings, I want to make sure the project's location is set up. I will also add a scale bar to my view. In this example, I have two Revit masses. One is my proposed building, and the second is an approved development. I also have a context model, which is a linked CAD. After setting up the view, I will go to the Adding toolbar and start Shadow Color. What we will do next is to link elements from the view and assign colors for the shadows. There are two ways to do so. We can pick elements directly from the view by clicking on Add Element, or we can select Worksets by clicking on Add Workset. I can pick any Revit massing, Revit links, groups, or any linked CAD or SketchUp. I will click Add Element, go back to my view, and pick the first element. The first element is going to be the top layer, in our case, the city context. The shadows of this layer will be on top. Under Color, I can select a color for the shadows element, and optionally adjust the opacity. I also have the option to keep the shadow configuration as in the view by selecting As View, or turn off the shadow by selecting None. I'll select dark gray. Now, let's click Add Element again and select the other elements from the view. This study has three layers: the city context, the approved, and the proposed building. I will click Preview Image and see the results. We can immediately see the view with the selected colors and the impact of the new development's shadows. On each layer, we can do a couple of things. We can reorder the elements with the arrows and decide which element's shadows will be on top. Under Action, we can disable or delete the element. Under Color, I can assign a color and adjust the opacity. I can create an outline for the shadows by clicking the outline checkbox, assigning color and changing the line width. I can assign a color for the overlapping shadows with the layer below. Under Appearance, I can do more advanced graphics. As View, the element will receive the shadows, as in Revit. Receive no shadows. The shadows cast on this element will be invisible. Invisible. Hide the element and keep the shadow shown. Sometimes I would want to see the additional shadow covering the park in a different color. In my case, my proposed building cast a shadow on the park. I can choose a different color for the shadow within the park and calculate its area. I will create a new site using the property line and name the site under the properties. I'll select Add Region on Shadow Color and pick the property line from the view. Under the region, I can change the color of the shadows within the site. When clicking on Preview Image, I can see the area calculations for each layer, including the overall region area. Under Setting, Preferences, I have additional graphic options. Control the shadow intensity. Turn off the area calculation. Show all elements in the view I hadn't picked. Override the line width. Bring the outline of the shadows to be on top. If you have topography in your Revit model, here you can choose the topography to use as the element to receive shadow. To save the settings and our selections, I can go to File and click Save Settings. To open the file, I'll go to File Open Settings. When opening the saved settings, Shadow Color will find and link all selected elements or worksets. when opening the save setting in a different Revit file, or in case the element has been removed from the view, I can manually relink elements and regions to the corresponding layer. The final step will be to export images. I'll go to File, Export, and here I can export a single image with the sun setting from view. Or I can export multiple images by selecting the time interval. To export, select the date, the time, and the time interval. Under Export Mode, I can choose File or place the images onto a sheet. Let's select File. Under Image Quality, I can select between Low, Medium, High, and Ultra. I can also export an image with all the frames overlaid, so I will leave the superposition image checked. I have the option to export a GIF animation. I will check the shadow area calculation to get an Excel sheet with the area calculation for each time frame. When selecting the export mode to be Sheet, I can select the title block and layout. As you can see, I got all the images here. The name of the files will be the date and the hour. I have the superposition image with overlaid shadows. And also, I have the GIF animation. In the Excel file, I can see my region's area calculation of the shadows for each time frame. Now I will export again. This time I will select to place the images on a sheet. Revit will create a new sheet and place the images with the date and the time as text below. The name of the images will be the date and the time accordingly. Thanks for watching.